Well, just to recap, 2011 has probably been the worst year for U.S.-Pakistan relations in recent history. It started with the Raymond Davis affair and then went on from the Osama bin Laden death in Abbottabad, then the allegations about Pakistan's links with the Haqqani network, and ending in this year with the Salalah airstrike in Pakistan, nearly cutting off all ties with the United States, closing off the NATO supply routes, things that they've done before in the past, but with more severity. And now that 2012 has begun, and this is also election year in the United States, and all eyes are going to be focused on how the U.S. And the Obama administration deals with the two major countries, Afghanistan and Pakistan. And in this vein, the State Department spokesperson Victoria Nuland yesterday, when she was giving her daily press briefing, said that the U.S. ambassador to Pakistan, Cameron Munter, has been in touch with Pakistan and that they want to get into a full counterterrorism relationship again, quote unquote. But at the same time, NATO supply routes still remain closed, so we don't really know how much what Ambassador Munter's efforts are, if they've been brought to fruit, or whether they will have any effect in softening the Pakistani side. Well, there have been various media reports about the drone strikes being put on hold until relations between Pakistan and the United States come back to normal. And this happened right after the NATO airstrike. There's also this other debate going on in the United States that there is no one left to kill in terms of high-value targets. And there is a lot of debate in the United States about whether it is worth the acrimony and the worsening of relations between Pakistan and the United States if drone strikes are only going to kill foot soldiers. Because if you look at it in the last few years, the United States says that it has captured or killed high-value targets, including in the last year. This is something that counterterrorism experts are probably going to be looking very closely at, whether there is anyone left, whether the drone strikes are worth the kind of fallout that they have in Pakistan. Well, the United States has already previously expressed reservations over the pipeline project. And yesterday at the State Department briefing, when they were asked about it, they said that they have made it clear that they have had concerns about the deal and that they will continue to talk to Pakistan. However, because Iran is already facing sanctions, legally it's not very clear whether Pakistan would face any kind of fallout. But again, with relations between the United States and Pakistan as tense as they are, it really is debatable how much pressure the United States can put on Pakistan to not participate in this pipeline project. And then eventually Pakistan can also turn around and say, then, well, if we don't do the pipeline deal with Iran, then is the United States willing to kind of help them with the pipeline project, or help them with energy generation in Pakistan, or energy power plant projects in Pakistan? So this really is a very touch and go game. And again, if the pipeline deal does go through, because of the acrimony about Iran here and about the negative and the state and the perception of Iran here and the opposition to Iran by the Congress and the White House, this deal will not be looked upon favorably in the U.S.